Yo, what up? It's February 8th, and the first Legacy Elusive target is out. It's called the Fugitive. Now, what is Legacy? That just means that there was a series of Elusive targets that came out in Hitman 1, and they are now running through them for the first time in Hitman 2. The Fugitive was, I believe, number 25 initially. Now it's going to be the first one in Hitman 2. Let's go ahead and watch the briefing video.
Good morning, 47. Your target has arrived at the Gamma facility in Hokkaido for facial reconstruction surgery. This gives us a window to engage, but the very nature of the surgery will make him difficult to identify. The clients are cooperating to gather information to identify the target, and I will relay this to you as I receive it. Be ready to improvise, however. The clock is ticking, 47. Good luck.
Alright, so as you can see, his face is blacked out, and there were three people who were featured in the briefing video. So why is this? That's because there are three NPCs that are always in the level. One has bandages over one of his eyes, one has bandages over one of his ears, and the other one has bandages near his nose. And every time you play this level, it'll randomly determine which one of those three is the target. So therefore, even if you're watching another video, their target might not be the same as yours. When you play it, if you restart, then you might get a different target this time. There's no way to know for sure. So most of the really cheap videos, what I mean is like the ones that have like a really cheap method of killing people, they will show you how to kill one of the three. And the idea is just go ahead and kill one of the three quickly and silently. If it's the target, then great. It'll tell you that it was a target and you can go ahead and leave. If it wasn't the target, then nothing will happen, and therefore you know that you've killed the wrong person, and therefore you can just simply restart. We are not going to go ahead and do that method. You can if you want, but I'm going to show you how to do it without having to rely on that restart. And I'm going to do it right now, just unequip everything, because if you don't have level 20 mastery, then you're not going to be able to bring a concealed weapon or two pieces of gear. You can go ahead and smuggle something in still, but we don't really need to do that. So I'm going to go ahead and show you how to do it without restarting.
Welcome to Hokkaido.
As soon as the level starts, just go ahead and skip the initial briefing. Not briefing, the initial camera pan. Go ahead and run to your bathroom and pick a pair of scissors.
Good hunting, 47.
You don't need to be, you know, doing this lightning fast necessarily, but you want to do it relatively quickly, because we want that hospital director's disguise, and there's a small window of opportunity to actually get it. So go ahead and run to the bathroom at the top of the ramp. Knock out that guy. Go into the bathroom on the right, throw him in the closet. We're gonna go and try to pick up the hospital director's disguise, because it's really powerful and it will allow us to find out who the target is. Now, Jason Portman is that dude right there. He's gonna walk by. Don't open the door such that he can see you. Wait for him to walk by first and then he'll walk away. Right when he walks away, the hospital director is gonna come up the ramp. When that happens, you want to, when he gets to the top of the ramp, he'll stand still, quickly open the door and throw the scissors in the bathroom, but make sure he can't see you. So yeah, I wasn't standing in the doorway, and that will attract his attention into the bathroom. Once he's there, you want to just knock him out. Retrieve the scissors. And then take him into the same bathroom as before, put him in the closet. And that's it for getting the hospital director's disguise. Now, once you do that, you want to run along to this wing, which is where the patients go. If you were in Jason Portman's outfit, you would go through this entryway. Continue this way. There are going to be no enforcers here as the hospital director. continue up this wing. Again, no enforcers here, which is great. First door to your right will be a stairwell. Just go upstairs. Now, once you get to this floor, there will be enforcers. I'll point them out to you. First one is the guy who's going to be in the room opposite the hallway. If you stand in front of the door at an angle where he can see you, he can see you through that door. So you want to be careful. You don't want to linger in front of him. So just quickly run past that door. The other one is this guy over here. He's going to patrol between two locations. The first location is next to this other guard, who stays still. The other location is in front of the office door. So you want to wait until he's coming back from in front of the office door. Then he'll walk this way and then he'll turn his back. This is the perfect opportunity to walk behind him and into your director's office. If you want, you can pick up this key card. I'll tell you what it does after. But what you really want to do is you want to use the computer, and then you want to pay attention to what Diana says, because she is going to tell you which of the three is your target. 47.
That will give us something to look for. Let me see what I can pull out of the data. It appears that the target has recently had rhinoplasty. Look for a patient with extensive bandages around his nose.
Okay, so mine is going to be the nose job guy. Alright, so once you've done that, you want to wait for this patrolling guy to once again be walking back towards that corner. Then you can safely walk past him. Walk back into the stairwell. Again, be careful of that guy. Just don't linger. Just don't walk too slowly. The next part is going to be optional. What I could do right now is to just go back to the beginning through this doorway, but I'm going to quickly show you what to do with that key card that I got. Also, while you're down here, you might as well take out the security tapes. So you just want to hang out in this room right here, get behind this guard, and then take him out. This is not strictly necessary, because we're not going to be walking in front of cameras, if we're careful. But you know, just as a matter of good practice, we might as well take it out. Now, if you run behind here, make sure this guy doesn't see you, but his back is always turned, so it should be okay. Walk over here, and if you picked up the nondescript key card, you can open this up. And basically, after this conversation, Agent Smith will give you an RFID chip that will allow you to open any door in the level. If you do this, just don't walk away until you get the chip. No one's going to come and harass you, so it's fine.
Right. So, what the hell are you doing here? No? Silent type, right. Yeah, me first. Okay. All right. I'm with Interpol now. I was working a case. Organ harvesting. Real bad business. And I followed the trail from Rio, but Dr. Ito, he's the one they call the curator. He found me snooping around and locked me up in the freezer. Okay, now you.
You should get out of here.
Yeah, good advice. That's right. Oh, wait. I found this in the curator's office. Knowing you.
Okay, there you go. Once you pick it up, you can go ahead and leave.
I managed to finalize the new instruction.
Okay, let's just not have an illegal weapon active. I like to switch over just in case I accidentally unholster. Alright, so once you have that, which was optional, go back up one flight of stairs. Not that way, but over here. And then what we're going to do is we're going to go all the way back to the beginning, where the bathroom is, and
Mr. Jason Porter,
you're going to want to change back into your default outfit.
A doctor will escort you to your
and the reason is because, technically, there will be fewer enforcers around, because if we go to the restaurant, right, I'll just quickly show you.
Please proceed to the hospital entrance.
If you go to the restaurant, there is that one bartender who can see through the director's outfit. And so you don't want to forget that he's there. So the foolproof way to do this is to just retrieve your default outfit, and then there really will be no enforcers. Okay, so here's one of the targets. This is the dude with his eye covered. If he's your target, wait until he stands kind of right here in this spot, and then basically what you can do is when you're in the bathroom, you can just throw an object and lure him in. Most likely when you first try to do that, this guard is going to be a little bit closer to the noise, and the game generally prioritizes a guard. Like if you throw something, a distraction, and multiple people hear it, if one of those people is a guard, it will usually tell the guard to go and investigate. And that's fine. You might want to actually just clear him out first. What I mean is, you throw the object, he'll come in, sneak up behind him, take him out, and then hide him in this bathroom right here. Yeah, there's no more closet space, but no one is going to come in here anymore. So you could actually hide as many people as you want in this room. Just remember that if you hide a body in this room, you don't want to open this door while there's another NPC around. So if I had the eye dude right now, what I would do is I would clear this. You know what? Let's just clear this guy out.
Okay.
Just so you know what I'm talking about. Right, so we're not going to open this door anymore while there's an NPC around. And we're always going to close it behind us. Alright. Alright, so let's look for a target. So, there are two people who generally hang out around here. Like, they'll go in and out, but they'll regularly come back over here. One of them is the eye dude, who I showed you earlier. And another is the ear dude. I believe both of them will walk by the bathroom, near the bathroom, at one point or another. And therefore, you can use the bathroom to kill them. The dude with the ear, I think, will also come up around here sometimes. So he will come up and stand where I'm standing, roughly. Another way you can kill him, it is a little bit risky because people might see you unless you check. But basically, while he's over there, you stand on the other side of the rock, so he can't see you, and then you throw the scissors by the railing. Make sure he can't see you, otherwise he'll yell at you, but otherwise he will walk over to the railing, and then at that point you just want to make sure that no one else is looking. Usually there will be no one looking, but just make sure that no one's looking over here. Like for example, if the helicopter pilot and Nails are exchanging the drugs, they might be able to see you, I'm not sure. Make sure they're not looking, and then you just push the guy over. While I'm here, I might as well pick up a hammer. Okay. But that's one way you can kill the guy who comes up here. I think it's the guy I'm talking about is this guy. Let me just verify that. If he goes up there, then he's the one that you can kill in the way I just described. He also walked by the bathroom earlier, just to clarify. So there's multiple ways. Yeah, so here you go. So I'll show you what I mean. So if he's up here, stand on the other side of the rock, throw an object by the railing.
What's that?
And then what I would do, he's not my target right now, but if he was, I would...
I don't even care.
Okay.
Just going through the motions.
See, here he's not close enough. That happens, you just wait. Let's try it again.
Huh? Hello?
And then, yeah, so now he's like this. If Nails and the pilot, or Nails and the surgeon were not there. Okay, I guess he's still a little too far away. You know, just keep trying until it works. You get the idea. He's not my target right now, though, so I'm not going to do that. Okay, so let's try to look for the... Who was he? Alright, so he was the eye dude. I'll quickly show you how to kill the ear dude. He might be hanging around here, I'm not really sure. Okay, well, that's the nose dude. That's my actual target. Maybe I'll just take care of him while I have him.
Good to see you.
I'm gonna follow him around for a little bit just so I can figure out where his path is. Briefly comes out of the garden, as you can see.
The scent.
Just
I know I seem like a broken record, but I can't smell shit.
It's like I'm seeing something out of the corner of my eye, but when I turn my head, it's gone.
That's funny. Last time I played this, it was someone else doing what he's doing. Okay. Alright, so, okay, alright, so he's already here, so I'm just gonna do this. I don't think he heard it. I'm just gonna keep bumping in him.
Say what?
Welcome.
I mean, when you have the opportunity, you might as well take it. Okay, I'm just gonna take him out.
Target eliminated. The money has been wired to your account.
Yeah, the last dude... I think they might actually change up their positions, too. Oh, wait, there he is. Okay, this is the air dude. So... basically, no matter who it is, it seems like at some point or another, they will walk by the bathroom. Like, here he is right here. They will walk by the proximity of this doorway. So, what you want to do is you just want to throw objects until you lure them into the bathroom, and then you can take them out. So, it's really as simple as that. When you're done, you can just quickly run down this ramp and exit from this tram. That's it. See you guys next time.